Only fools rush in, but I can't help falling in love with you.
Hi everyone, Matt James here. Welcome to another guitar tutorial, and today I'm going to show you how to play the Elvis Presley classic Can't Help Falling in Love, which was made famous for being in his film Blue Hawaii, which was released in 1961, and I believe was the highest grossing film of 1961. So there you go. Really great love song, very popular Elvis song, quite a nice one for beginners as well, especially if you're learning finger picking. This is sort of quite a nice gateway into finger picking. It's played in triplets as this one. We've got the capo on the fifth fret today, and we're in standard tuning, so without further ado, we'll get to a close-up and I'll teach you how to play it. Alright, so to start with, for the verse, we are looking at a C chord, and the finger-picking pattern you want to start with doing, because we're playing triplets, it goes like this. So I'm starting with my thumb on the A string, the fifth string, and you're literally just moving down the strings with each finger. So thumb, fifth, first finger, fourth string, yeah, second finger on the G string, third string, and then you want your third finger on the B string, so like this, and then back again, so, and then back again for your second finger on the D string, or the G string, sorry, second finger on the G string, and your first finger back to the D string, so. Basically playing that pattern throughout the whole thing, but I do change it up a little bit. So to start with, when we're playing a C chord, it's wise to an E minor, and then for the rest of it, it's the same pattern of literally just following the strings up and down in like that sort of arpeggio type style. But for the E minor, I'm playing the bottom E string with my thumb, and then again using my first, second and third finger, which I'm going to be using throughout the whole song in that pattern, I'm actually playing the top three strings, so the third, second and first strings, D, B and E string. So it's wise. So you can choose to do it like that, just playing your bass note, which is usually on the A or the E string, and then using your first, second, and third fingers to play the top three strings all the time. You can do it like that. I sort of alternate, really. Sometimes I'll play it doing that, like I showed you at the beginning. But if you want to go to start with, that is also absolutely fine. So whatever you prefer, you can do a bit of both. So it's alternate between that. So for the verse, we're looking at C, E minor, A minor, then an F, only fools, C, then G, and back to F, but I, G, can, C, L, then a D minor, fall, C, G, and C. And yeah, so all I'm doing for that is, like I was saying, just that finger picking pattern of, for all the chords, your first, second, third finger are always playing these top three strings, and then your thumb is basically playing the bass note. For that's for your A minor, and F, G, C, D minor, also playing the D. But yeah, your three fingers really want to be rooted here, and then your thumb is just oscillating between whatever the bass note is, and that's it for the finger picking style. It's quite straightforward, but I'd say quite a nice one if you're just getting into finger picking. So that's the verse, and then there's actually sort of like the chorus or bridge bit, whatever you want to call it, where it goes like a river flows, and that just alternates between E minor to B7.
Darling, so it goes,
and then it goes E minor again for the last one, then A7. Then it goes to D minor, to a G. And then you're back into the main. So that's it, really. I mean, it just structure-wise, I have done another video of me playing this as a straightforward cover. So feel free to watch that if you want to get the structure of it exactly. Obviously, listen to the original as well. Elvis, when he did it live in the 70s, did it quite a bit different to this. He sort of made it a bit faster. And that version's great as well, but I'm very much going off the 1961 original. But yeah, that's it. That's Can't Fall in Love. It really is quite straightforward, but a really nice one. So I hope that was useful as ever. If there's anything that didn't make sense or you think I could have improved on, do let me know in the comments. But I do hope that was useful for you. And until then, I'll see you in the next one.